Hello Cloud Gurus, I'm Nigel Poulton, the author of a new book, Quick Start Kubernetes, and this is Kubernetes This Month, the show that keeps you right up to date with the big stuff going on in the Kubernetes universe. First up, here's my top 5 Kubernetes news items for the past month. Google continues its support of the project financially. Container security and utilization, GKE CSI driver goes GA, Anthos and Nutanix, and some Docker news. Starting things off, Google continued its support of Kubernetes and the CNCF with $3 million worth of cloud credits to be used for things like, well, hosting the projects, of course, but also for testing infrastructure and for supporting the 100 million daily image downloads they see. So I'm left wondering what I would do with $3 million worth of cloud credits. In fact, what would you do with $3 million worth of cloud credits? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, Sysdig's 2021 Container Security and Usage Report is out, and it's got some fascinating insights that I want to dig into. So I'll park it for now, but we'll pick it up later in the deeper dive section. Now, the GKE CSI driver is GA, and it is installed by default on all clusters in the Rapid channel. Now, aside from the basics, it supports encrypted volumes and volume snapshots, a real step in the right direction towards stateful apps and persistent data if you're running your apps on GKE. Now, sticking with Google, Nutanix announced support for Google Anthos on their hyperconverged infrastructure. More on this one as well in the deeper dive section. Docker Inc. announced Justin Cormack as CTO. Congrats to both Docker and Justin there, a very well-deserved appointment in my opinion. They also open-sourced their Hub CLI tool, and their open-source registry got accepted as a CNCF sandbox project. So a good month for Docker. Now, I know I said I had 5 news updates, and I do, but I just want to let you all know that A-Cloud Guru is hosting a webinar on creating a centralized app deployment process using Kubernetes, Azure, and the HashiCorp stack. Details are in the show notes. And you know what? That about wraps up the news for this month. Now, we ran through the news items pretty quickly, but I want to take a closer look at the following 2 items that I think you need to take a closer look at this month. So they are the Sysdig Container Utilization and Security Report and Nutanix supporting Anthos. Okay, so I'll be upfront with you. I love reports like this. You get a little glimpse into what's actually going on in the wider world. Well, for starters, and I recommend you look through it yourself, but 74% of Sysdig users, and this report is based on data from Sysdig customers, okay? But 74% are scanning container images before deployment. Now, they're calling this a shift to the left as the scanning is being done earlier in the pipeline, but it's all really good stuff. Now, not so good stuff being 54% of containers are running as root, so privileged. Now, look, I get that there are technologies that filter syscalls and the likes and kind of mitigate this, but it's still not a good stat. Now, this one I find really interesting, especially as Kubernetes recently announced deprecation of the Docker container runtime. So, of Sysdig customers, use of Docker as the container runtime dropped by 37% down to 50%. So, don't get me wrong, 50% of customers are still using the Docker runtime, but it's down 37% on the previous year. Now, picking up the slack here is Containerd and Cryo, both of which were up 2x on the previous year, Containerd grabbing 33% of nodes. Now, there's more in the report, but those are my highlights. Okay, so Nutanix just announced you can run Google Anthos on their hyperconverged infrastructure. So Anthos is all about managing Kubernetes workloads, well, wherever the heck you want them. So Kubernetes Anywhere, I think, is one of their taglines. It supports GKE, of course, AWS, and I think Azure, plus a bunch of on-prem options, but that now includes Nutanix. So look, if you're looking for a potentially easy and scalable way to get Kubernetes on-prem, and I'm talking the full stack, right? So servers, networking, storage, and all that kind of hardware, plus Kubernetes and management of workloads, the whole thing lock stock, right? This might be for you. So Nutanix is all about hyper-converged infrastructure, which is really a buzzword for all of your infrastructure hardware needs neatly packaged in scalable units that are fully supported. And of course, they're highly available and high performance. In fact, it's cloud-like infrastructure for on-prem. So that's Nutanix. And then with Anthos support, you're adding management of Kubernetes workloads. And suddenly, we might be looking at a great way to get all cloud-native in your on-premises data centers. Well, that's it for this month's episode of Kubernetes This Month. If you like the show, be sure to give the episode a big thumbs up. If you've got a question, add it into the comments. Stay safe, and I'll be here again next month, so don't forget to subscribe. Same cube time, same cube place.